The Tom Leykis Show from Los Angeles. We are talking with Mel Fite. He is the director of an organization called the National Center for Men. Their website, nationalcenterformen.org. Link through our website, blowmeuptom.com. And the National Center for Men is getting involved in a lawsuit in Michigan. A 25-year-old computer programmer who's been ordered to pay child support for his ex-girlfriend's daughter. His argument is, hey, I don't want to be a father. She knew I didn't want to be a father. I just want to opt out. Let me think about that. It's James on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hey, Tom, how you doing?
Great.
It's good. Hey, I completely agree with your guest that you have on today. But I do have a couple of questions. I am in that situation and have been for quite some time. The child that I'm involved with right now is a teenager. But my question is, if what they're trying to do is successful, will that then allow individuals like myself who has had to deal with that bad type of situation, will that allow us the opportunity to get some type of repercussions for what has happened to us?
Yeah, I doubt it. I'm sorry to bring bad news to you. I don't think anybody's looking backward in at this. So I wouldn't count on that. I mean, you know, who knows what'll happen, but I doubt that that's going to happen. Sorry. I do want to say one thing about what we're doing to as a solution, which is we have come out with this reproductive rights affidavit. It's not an official legal document. Men should not consider it an official legal document, file it with the court, and hope that that's going to solve the problem for them. But it is a proposed solution. We take it seriously. And it is available through our website for small donations. We are trying to fund a lawsuit, which could get very expensive here. And we ask people to understand, if you want a copy of the affidavit, we ask for small donations in return. But you can get all that information at National centerformen.org. I would like to see a man be able to use the reproductive rights affidavit and make a choice one way or the other.
Jenny on the Tom Leykis Show from Mel Fite. Hello.
Hi, Tom. I had a question for Mel. It was in regards to the role reversal, like he's been mentioning the whole time. I agree with the whole, you have, you know, you both sides should have a fair say in who have an abortion and whatnot. But my question would be, if a man was to actually lie to a woman and promise to have a child with her, and then all of a sudden come out and say, I don't want to have anything to do with, you know, with her as soon as she gets pregnant. I was looking at, you know, the whole scenario and wondering, you know, about the, you know, you were talking earlier about the financial responsibilities, and I wanted to know what kind of situation that would look like.
To me, morally speaking, I am not on that man's side. I'm not countenancing reproductive fraud, but now the woman has the option to pursue him and to collect child support from him. So, you know, I would not be on a man's side.
Right.
Who lied.
Right. My question would be, if there was a financial responsibility that was involved for both of them to be together, and then he promises her that, you know, he's going to have his part in financially or whatever, and then he, you know, he backs out, and then she's actually forced to probably get an abortion because she's not financially stable enough to have the baby by herself. Like, what kind of situation would that, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but she has a right at that point to go to court, to get the authorities to go to court for her and to collect child support from him. You know, as a moral proposition, I'm not going to be on the side of any man who lies to a woman. I don't want men to do that, but I want...
Well, I'm not talking about morality. I'm talking about, like, you know...
Legally, she can sue him, though. She can go after him and say, you know, I want you to pay child support. And although I think... Sad to say, I think as a matter of law, he should have choice because a woman has choice. From a moral point of view, I don't want to be on the side of a man who lies to a woman any more than I'd be on the side of a woman who lies to a man. And it's this situation that you described. She can go to court. She can force him to be responsible. She's protected. The law protects her.
Thank you for the call, Jenny. It's Wayne on the Tom Leykis Show from Mel Fite. Hello.
Tom and Mike, hey. The question I have is, is there some sort of legal document that a lawyer can prepare or put together that would hold up in court where if both the man and women decide not to have kids, that the woman could sign that and would hold up in court and not hold him responsible in the future?
There should be. There isn't. The courts take the position, as far as I know, that the child support obligation is owed to the child and not to the mother. Therefore, a man and woman cannot sign away a responsibility that, in fact, is owed to a child, the courts will not hold that enforceable as against you know, public policy. It's that the child needs to be protected. As a practical matter, who are we kidding? A woman can get an exorbitant amount of child support from a man, and the law doesn't even require her to spend that child support on the child. It can be extortion. It can be just money that she collects from a man that she sets up, and there should be some document that the two of them can sign beforehand, but right now there isn't.
Wow. So just because the child is another entity, then the document wouldn't hold up because it doesn't have to do with the child.
I'm not a lawyer, but my understanding from talking to lots of lawyers is that the theory is that the obligation to child support is owed to the child is entitled to it, and the two adults cannot relinquish a right that the child has.
Jules on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Hey, I wish you guys all the best tomorrow. I think it's great.
Thank you.
I have four kids of my own, and I support all four kids, always have, but I feel like if a woman is going to take the chance, she wants to open up her legs. A lot of times the reason she gets pregnant is because of unconditional love, or she's trying to hang on to the man, and I really believe a man has a choice. One of my four children is a son, and I would love for him to have that option. I don't think anybody should be trapped, and life is too short. You know, 18 years is a long time to have to take care of something you don't want to take care of. I'm very grateful for all my kids, but I wish you guys the best of luck tomorrow.
Thank you. I appreciate it. It's a large burden that's imposed on a man who's forced into, you know, he feels violated with every paycheck. I appreciate your support, and I think that you're going to bear out what I said before. There are mothers out there, women who are going to look at this young man, Matt Dubay, and are going to say, that could be my son. And those women are going to be on our side.
Jules, thank you for the call. Our guest, Mel Fite of the National Center for Men in New York City. This is Jason on the Tom Leykis Show. Hello.
Tom, Mel, how are you guys?
Hi.
Great.
Hey, you know, I think this is a great step in equality. Women for so long fought for women's rights and to be equal with men. Well, now it's time. Welcome to the equality. The reason being is that I have a friend who has two children. The mother of those two children wants nothing to do with them. Does she have to pay child support? No. Did they agree to have the children? Yes. She wants nothing to do with them. It's time for women to stop holding it over our heads. Not only that, they should be able to be responsible enough that if they're going to be immature and force us into that situation, they need to be held accountable for it as well.
Yeah, I object to the hypocrisy of what I find in the women's movement. And, you know, women now default on court-ordered child support at a rate about twice as much as men, seldom ordered to pay child support even when they should be. When was the last time you saw the authorities rounding up all these mothers who don't pay? I mean, the bias in the family court system is just incredible.
It's ridiculous, and I really think what you're doing is a great thing, not only for men, but for women, too.
Yeah, I agree with you. I absolutely think that equal partnership between men and women in which rights and responsibilities are really shared, I think that kind of a world would be great for women as well as men. I do not see this as a men versus women thing. This is a campaign for equal partnership. Women will benefit from this as much as men will. Yeah, I agree with you completely.
And kids, for that matter.
Absolutely right. And children, the thing about kids is that they grow up to become adults. And we have a responsibility to try to create a world for them that's a little fairer, more just than the world that we inherited. That's what we're trying to do here. Because, you know, some of the children born now will become men and women. We want them to have a world in which they have equal rights.
Mel, if people want to get involved with your organization or want to help you specifically even with this case, what can they do?
Go to nationalcenterformen.org. We're a little swamped now with press interviews, but, you know, if they get to us, we'll get back to them within a few days. Go to the website. There's information about how to call us. We'll if you want to help, we need the help now because we're trying to do this lawsuit. It's going to take help. So people, go to nationalcenterformen.org. Information about how to contact us is there. Do that. Help us out if you want. We have good lawyers working on this. We might surprise people. The state of Michigan might underestimate us because we have several good lawyers working on these briefs. It's an uphill battle, but we're going to make a really good showing.
All right, that's nationalcenterformen.org.
Nationalcenterformen.org. Please visit the website. Please help us if you can. This is going to be a difficult, expensive battle. Call us up, and we'll talk about how you can get more involved.
Mel, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, Tom.
Appreciate it. Mel Fite, director of the National Center for Men. Their website, nationalcenterformen.org. And we'll be watching this case. Our email address is my name. It's Tom@blowmeuptom.com. That's Tom at blowmeuptom.com.
The Tom Leykis Show.